Hi and Merry Christmas! Did you know that each Australian state has its own Christmas bush? But before we go national, it's important to realize that the term Christmas bush is loose. It captures a variety of plants, all from different plant families, including one orchid and one parasite. So let's have a look at them. Hi, I'm Jan from sustainablebutterflies.com.au. We are on a mission to make Australian educational and care organizations sustainable, frugal, and improve their carbon footprint. The link to our website is in the description below. Okay, let's start in New South Wales, Sydney, Haberfield. I am next to this beautiful New South Wales Christmas bush, Ceratopetalum gummiferum. They've been very popular since early colonial times, and that's because around Christmas time they turn red. So they used for Christmas decoration. Now, the red bits are actually not flowers. Flowers are white, tiny, inconspicuous flowers that form around October. And then by Christmas time, it's 19th of December today, they would have been pollinated and fell off. And what remains, the red bits, are sepals, the unripe fruit. Now, let's briefly talk about its growth habit. So in cultivation around Sydney, around urban areas, they hardly exceed 5 meters in height, and they're a bit wider. And that's for two reasons. Reason number one is because people like to prune them after the end of flowering seasons for decoration, and that encourages that growth habit, the wider growth habit, and they hardly exceed 5 meters. But to contrast that, in nature, in the rainforest, which is their natural habitat, they can grow up to 15 meters and they're a bit narrower and taller. This is actually more towards its natural growth habit. And the reason why they grow taller and narrower in nature, in the rainforests, it's obvious, because they have to reach high towards the sun. Now, as far as soil requirements go, they tolerate a wide variety of soils from sandy to clay, but perform best in sandy soils. They will grow in clay soils as long as they are not too salty and have reasonable drainage. Now, as far as its uses go, apart from their beautiful red color and them being Christmas bush, it's a beautiful screen tree. It does need a little bit of wind protection. It doesn't like exposed coastal locations because it's a rainforest tree. Now, there is a high degree of color variation here. They are not all as beautifully red as this one. I asked the neighbor, he allowed me to shoot the video here, and he said that he sprinkles coffee grounds on the tree, on the leaves, but not on the soil because that would be too strong, too acidic for the tree. And if you want to grow it in your suburb, it was recommended by TAFE teachers, horticulture teachers, to actually walk around your suburb, and if you see them grown, then it's highly likely that they will survive in your area. But if you don't see them in your suburb, it's likely that you won't be successful in growing them. Anyway, I don't know, that's what they taught us. Okay, now let's go national, and we will start in Victoria. Victorian Christmas bush, Prostanthera lasiantos, is in the Lamiaceae family, the main family. It's very hardy, adaptable, fast-growing, ideal screen plant. It tolerates heavy shade to full sun. The Tasmanian and South Australian Christmas bush, Bursaria spinosa, is in the Pittosporaceae family, or cheese woods family. It's very hardy and adaptable plant, often used in floral arrangements. The Western Australian Christmas bush, Nutsia floribunda, is in the mistletoe family. It's the largest mistletoe in the world. It's a root parasite, and the way it grows is it attaches its roots to the roots of the host species, but it forms flowers and fruits itself. So it's not total parasite, unlike balloon vine or Madeira vine, which just smothers the host species and kills it. There is a little bit of symbiotic relationship going on. And look at the spectacular yellow flowers. it's very hard, unlike the other plants, it's very hard to grow in cultivation. And the final Christmas bush for today is actually Queensland Christmas orchid in the Orchidaceae family or orchid family called Calathea triplicata. It needs warm and moist and shaded location because naturally it grows in a rainforest. It's an ideal pot plant and will grow up to 1.5 meters. Now, we finished, but this got me thinking about actually cutting all these millions and hundreds of millions of fresh small pines that we use for 2 weeks for Christmas if we don't use the plastic ones, and then we just discard them. So how about we celebrate native local Christmas bushes, and we can just perhaps decorate them or cut little bits for decorations, and maybe that's good enough, isn't it? Like, why do we need to keep cutting all of these small trees for 2 weeks? I don't know. Thank you very much. I really appreciate your time. I hope you enjoyed the video. We are sustainablebutterflies.com.au, and who are we doing this for? For the environment, future generations, plants, animals, including butterflies. You have a great Christmas.